Hello everybody. In this little video I'm going to describe a marvelous tool for determining the actual volume of your MP3 files before uploading them. Welcome to another help video for LibriVox recorders. This is PC Phil Chenevert with a video showing an easy way of determining the volume level of your MP3 recordings. Well, that is if you're using Windows. It doesn't seem to work with Mac. But this neat program called MP3GAin will tell you the volume level of your MP3 recordings, and it will give you a recommendation of the amount to increase or decrease the volume to achieve the desired 89 decibels. Now, the volume of our recordings can vary greatly. This is a picture I took of three different recordings I made. The top one is very puny and weak because the waves are very small. They hover around that middle line. The middle one looks like it's way too high. In fact, they even had a lot of clipping right here and here. And the last one looks like it would be a normal recording for me. We'll check it out in a minute. The volume that LibriVox likes us to have when we upload files is 89 decibels, or at least something close to it. Let's say within 4 decibels of that. Anywhere from 86 to 93 is acceptable, I've been told. But even that isn't set in stone. 89 just gives us something to shoot at. So how do you do it? Well, I've recorded this particular audio with MP3 with Audacity, and I'm going to drag it into the box. We're going to cover this first. First thing it tells me is that our normal volume is 89.3. This can be changed. It tells me the volume right here. The volume is 71.7, and it tells me it's recommending a track gain of 18.1. Okay, do not use track gain. This will automatically adjust certain things inside of your recording. We don't want to use that. To adjust this thing, we're going to open up that file in whatever editing program you use. Use Audacity. Now, this is my little anemic file, apparently. I'll select the whole file, go to Effect, then Amplify, and it asks me how much. Now, when you open up Audacity, the amplify box will tell you the absolute maximum that you can amplify without clipping. Now, in this case, it's 18.2. I'm just going to change that to 18.1. And this means it's going to come within 1/10 of a decibel of clipping. But it won't actually clip. Click OK. Now, you may be able to see that this file is much bigger. Now, if you were doing this for LibriVox, or if I was doing it, I would export it one more time using the exact same file name that I used before, which is whatever it is, low volume 1. Save it in the same place. Clear the thing and see if I can drag it in here and do it. If I can't, well, it's going to give me problems. Let's analyze it. I have now increased that to 89.3, which is very close and very acceptable. So at that point, I could export this or upload it to LibriVox, and it would be fine. Okay, let's clear this and load another one. I call this normal volume. 89.1. That's pretty darn close. In this case, I wouldn't do anything to it but upload the file. I call high volume because it's kind of high volume. Analyzes it and tells me it's 95.7 decibels. Let's see if I can amplify that again. 95.7. This is a little tool, I think it's called magnifying glass. It's recommending a negative 6.0. That means it says, why don't you go back and reduce it? So that's what we're going to do. So I will open up this file in Audacity. Select it. Once again, go to Effect, Amplify. And I'm going to type in negative 6. And let's see what's going to happen here. Whoa. Well, that certainly did reduce it. That's a nice, pretty file now. Once again, I'll do the same thing. I will export it using the same name that I used before, because it's been modified. And let's see if it gives me anything. Track analysis, 89.2. So what it recommends will come pretty close. Now, the track gain or negative is only in steps of 1.5 decibels. However, you don't have to use what they're recommending. If your volume here is showing 80, and they have something else, you can know. Well, increase it by 9, and you'll come up to 89. You can use your own estimation on these things. Now, these are pretty normal files. Now, what happens if you have clipping or peaks? Let's see if this one works here. One of the problems with these files, with some files, is that they have clipping. Now, a clipping is when your volume is so loud that it exceeds the program's capability to record it, and so you lose the bits at the top or at the bottom. You'll notice that this particular file has, yes, clipping, and the whole track has clipping in it. So it's recommending to gain 4.5. Now this is the actual file. And you can see that some of my waveforms here go pretty high. I'm just amplifying them, that's all. So we can see this one here is the one that's clipping. And an interesting point or aside, if you have trouble with a lot of clipping, you can go to View, and there's a little thing here that says Show Clipping. But this means is as you're recording and you have a clip, it'll pop up in red, and you can immediately stop and re-record that. So, but let's assume that you don't normally have trouble. Shrink this back down. So, if we tried to amplify this file, it would not allow us to amplify a file. Say 00. It says you can't amplify this file at all. So, how can we do this? Well, this is how I do it. I would zoom in on that particular file there, whatever it is. Here it is, right here. Highlight it. And negative amplify. Let's say negative 4. Shrinks it right on down. Now, if I may have lost, yes, I may have lost a little bit of the peaks up there. Here's another one that we want to de-amplify. I'm going to amplify that so I can get it. I mean, not amplify it. I'm going to zoom in. That's it. And choose that. Go to Effect, Amplify, and a negative 3. I'm just choosing these numbers because this is about what I would look for. Next, I'm going to look at the entire file by clicking up here. Whoops, I still have one right here. Tricky, tricky, Phil. Tricky, tricky. Effect, amplify, negative 4. I like negative 4. Once again, I'll go here so I can put my entire track in one thing. I can see that it's pretty good. Now, let's see how much I can amplify it. I can amplify by 4. And I think they recommended 4, so let's try it. I still have these clicks, but we'll see what happens here. I'm going to export it as peak, same file name. Clear it, and let's see if I drop peaks in here, what it'll do. Track analysis, 88.1. Now, it shows that I would still have a clip. It's saying if you amplify by 1.5, you're going to have a clip. Well, I don't want to amplify it anymore. That's just fine with me. And if you want to know what decibels are, well, you can ask somebody else because I'm not sure. I do know that the format used in MP3 gain is called a SPF or something. It means how does a human ear hear the sound? How loud does it sound to the human ear? So it's sort of a different formula, but it works very well. Disclaimer, remember, this is all my opinion and may or may not represent the views of those people who actually know what they're doing. A warranty is void if used while immersed in buttermilk. Thank you very much.